What is up, everybody? It's Jordan with On the Coast Realty, and we are headed to one of my favorite places in the world, Masonboro Island. Masonboro Island is an 8-mile-long barrier island ecosystem that runs north to south along the Wilmington coastline. It's part of the North Carolina National Estuarine Research Reserve. Basically just means it's federally protected from any forms of development. The island is over 5,600 acres, but 87% of that is marsh and tidal flats. So let's talk about how to get there. Unless you're Michael Phelps, which if you are, shout out, I'm a huge fan, Masonboro is only really accessible by boat. What you're seeing here is the southernmost tip of the island, only about a 2-mile boat ride from the Carolina Beach boat ramp. This is actually the only part of the island that the beach runs continuously from the ocean to the intercoastal. Another access point I'd recommend is Trails End Park. I will say accessing the actual beach on this part of the island is a little difficult, just because there's so much marsh, but this is an amazing spot to explore with a kayak or a stand-up paddleboard. A third spot I really like is this cove towards the north end of the island. This cove is really cool because once you get parked, it's a super short walk to the beach. There do tend to be a few oyster beds in here, so definitely be careful jumping out. Last but not least, we have my personal favorite, the northernmost tip of the island. This part of the island is only 3 miles from Wrightsville Beach boat ramp. It actually has a sandy beach on the back side of the island, which is perfect for the days with strong onshore winds. This shot is at dead low tide, which, as you can see, does make parking the boat a little dicey. But once that tide fills in some, the water actually runs all the way back behind the shrubbery, which makes things a lot easier. All right, now that the boat is parked, let's make our way across.
Walking across Masonboro is always the coolest thing to me. I mean, you're literally 10 minutes from the ramp, and you feel like you're just on some island in the middle of nowhere.
After a quick boat ride and a short little stroll across, you walk over the dunes and see this. So many things to do on these beaches. Dogs and overnight camping are both allowed year round. Surf fishing here is phenomenal. There's an amazing beach break beside the jetty for surfing. The list goes on and on. There are a few things to be cautious about when coming over to the island. At the top of the list, tides. If possible, always try to park the boat when the tide is rising. If you do happen to time it on a falling tide, just make sure you chuck on the boat more than you think you need to. Another thing I'd be cautious about is coming over during the major holidays, especially 4th of July. The island fills up with thousands of people on those days, makes getting in and out of parking spots feel like playing bumper cars with other boats. One final thing, as easy as it may look from the beach, please do not try to swim or paddle across from South End. Currents are crazy, the boat wakes get massive, and it is just not worth it. Even for you, Michael Phelps. That's all I have for this one. Thank you so much for watching, and we will see you on the next one.